All right. Starting right off the bat by getting to fuck this cat. Yeah, so today we're going to be playing a little bit more. So we still have kind of a couple things we can do. More or less, it's the Chamber of Extinction or the Temple of the Moon. And so I want to go to the Temple of the Moon. I feel like Moon is a good spot to go. There's a lot of good stuff we can do here. Now there is that mysterious ladder. The old puzzle here used to be that you have to hit these with a certain weapon. But that does not appear to be the puzzle this time. So that was the thing I forgot. I was just thinking about it. I was like, oh yeah, I put the weight on the pedestal, but I was supposed to search that instead. Those Anubises can deal quite a bit of damage. But it's fine, we got the thing that we needed to get. Which was the last of the four secret points. Going to be going up here, past the Temple of the Moon. So the main puzzle in the Temple of the Moon is obviously the moon temple itself over there. That's kind of the big feature, but we can't do anything with that. Instead, we need to come here. Oh, and we need to solve this puzzle. So. We have to open them from left to right. How are we gonna do that? Well, we have to try to guess or remember which one goes where. So that is the fourth one. Second one. Oh, what a bumble. Let's try that again. Should probably clear out these enemies first. Just so they don't bump me. Get away from me, bat. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cost me a couple extra weights, but that's okay. I got the Fruit of Eden. You might be thinking, what is the Fruit of Eden? Well, we're gonna find out. I only have 8 weights to go. So this is in La-Mulana's, these are the ancient writings, and the picture there is, I don't know, what is that, 7 stones and a other symbol. That is a late game puzzle, obviously, because we can't read it. So here we are in Eden. It looks like a very nice place to be. But we're gonna find out that that is not the case. A paradise deep in the fog. Clear the fog and you'll be surrounded by more happiness. Head for the Tree of Eden with the fruit of paradise in hand. Alright. So. Oh. So we put a wait here. Oh no, it wasn't paradise. Here's the Tree of Eden. We are actually in the Gate of Illusion. Welcome to the paradise of the Eternally Lost. In times past, this place was called Eden. Now it is the accursed site of war, where vengeful spirits are lost, wandering the paths of life. Those who enter Eden do not make light of this place. Alright, I'm glad we got a wait, because we're gonna need a few waits to get through this area. Simply wandering will not lessen the illusion. Courage will grant thy wish, the courage to jump into the illusion, the courage to search on bended knee for a single fallen item. So this area is going to require some courage to get through. Let's go ahead and check our mail. It's me. You think there's nothing there, then all of a sudden you find yourself on a strange path. Just a story I heard in the village. What looks like a dead end might actually warp you to another place. How strange. But then again, strange is the norm in La-Mulana. You know, I want to use my limited flares. One fool believed in his foolishness that he was a wise man. The fool flaunted his shallow wisdom and made decisions with narrow mind. He proceeded to the right without hesitation. Another fool possessed wisdom, but his knowledge led him to believe he was a fool. A fool who smothers himself without first considering the situation. He went with the flow and proceeded to the left. One can only hope that the true wise man stands here now. So, we have learned that going to the right is wrong, going to the left is wrong, so let us stand. We're standing here now. Right. Is that wrong? Am I supposed to go down, up? Seems to be writing here, it's impossible to decipher. There we go. So we needed to search on this light. There's another clue, actually, that this light does not, doesn't go up and down. It doesn't, like, brighten and dim like the other lights. It's just sort of stationary. And there's a hole in the ground now. Thy understanding is impressive, wise one. Be thee a wise man or a fool, thine actions shall reveal the truth, in hopes that thou art the true wise man. So, we are the true wise man, of course. But part of being the true wise man is that we need to make it through this teleporter maze. Well, we might need to trigger the teleporter maze first. It seems like that doesn't do it. Ladder. I can go to the left for weights. Alright, well, I guess I... Oh yeah, so this is the one of the cool paths. Can go this way. Sure. Let's try it. There is a treasure here, but it's not the treasure we yet. I feel like we should continue going. We're gonna go down here to the graveyard of the giants. Out of the way. Okay. Me? I'm not bold. Ice is slippery. Can't be helped. Good luck. So, he's actually telling us there is no way to avoid ice in this game. Ice is just ice. Tojin emits countless beams of light. Those without a white shimmer will not survive. Okay. I don't remember what that means. Alright, at least that guy's dead. Can we actually push this off? But we need to get it over there. We have a puzzle to solve. Alright, now we can get back up. So that's good. Before we go to the right, we might actually want to go to the left. Yeah. Fluff balls, they're pretty cute. Let's go in here. All the items are genuine, grab them while you can. This baby's guaranteed 100% genuine silver shield. And he's got some overpriced, some overpriced weights. And yeah, we've got this big giant skeleton hanging out here. We're not gonna buy the genuine silver shield. And the reason for that is it's not genuine. It is a fake silver shield. He's lying to us. Turns out giants suck. We'll find a clue about that a little bit later. I am worried that I'm gonna do this wrong. So this puzzle is one that doesn't reset, and it's fine if you get it, if you don't do it right. It just makes jumping in this area really annoying if you do it wrong. Alright. Okay. I think that was the right way to do it. Those seeking Eden, open the four boxes. Seek four pedestals within the hands of the four who reside in place bathed in moonlight. So that's a clue to the Temple of the Moon, which means it's possible to get here without having gone through the Temple of the Moon. Is that the right way? God, I hope that was the correct way. Yeah. The illusion has no end. The key to eternity rests within. A demon with a weapon brings forth the illusion. A demon that endlessly consumes life. Well, we've heard about a demon that consumes life. And we've heard about a key of eternity. Those are things we want. And that's apparently in the place we just came from. But we're not really ready for that. Oh, we really want to come from above, I think. Oh, that's the Temple of the Moon. Red ruby means passion. The sapphire signifies affection. Okay, this I am gonna record. And we're almost out of weights. But, yeah, so the way that we can get here is actually from here. Yep, the graveyard of the giants connects to the mausoleum of the giants, which is not surprising. But yeah, that's one way we could have gotten here. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so that's open. Unfortunately, getting back up is a bit of a pain. That's all right. Actually made it. Can we do anything with this? I think there's probably a glitch where you can maybe glitch through that wall or something, but we can't do that. Maybe somebody else could do it, but not us. Oh, I want that mark. That's cheated me out of some coins. That's alright. This is also a pretty good theme, to be honest. So there is a chest down there. My eyes are not hollowed out holes. Yes, that's a clue. His eye can be destroyed. About as far as we're gonna get there. We're totally out of weights. That's right, they don't sell weights in town anymore. We can buy the computer. I guess we can do that. Alright, you gonna sell me weights now? Alright. Kind of an expensive way to get weights, but we're gonna need that computer eventually, I think. Maybe you don't. I actually don't know if you need it. What the computer does is we have twice as much memory. That's, I think, all that it does, but it might be, it might unlock something. Once you do it, there might trigger a story flag of some kind. But alright, so the fastest way to get back into the Mausoleum of the Giants, or rather the Graveyard of the Giants, is going to be go through here. And it sort of starts us off, oh yeah, we don't have a map. Sort of starts us off more towards the bottom. Which means we won't be able to get that chest. But there is, okay, so something I did created that platform. What we really want to do is follow into this left path. It's a little annoying to go through there, but it works. Alright, so now we have a puzzle. There is a thing over here. This fake. Anyway. Pretty sure that's a fake, fake pedestal. In reality, what we're gonna do and drop this block. Now we're gonna drop this block. And then we're gonna say we can't actually do that. Let's get to the top first. Climb up that thing. I think the answer is yes. That area to the left is pretty exciting. But we can't do anything useful there, so I'm not even gonna bother. Yeah, I don't know if I can get that one yet. Let's not worry about that. Let's do this puzzle. Right? Is that right? Okay. And then I push this. This! That was too much. Oof. Managed to dodge a lightning by using some invulnerability frames. That's not me. So we certainly have to push that. Have to push it carefully. Quite get up there. Do I need a double jump to do this? Alright, well, I really want that thing. Let me keep looking at this. Some way to do this that I'm forgetting. All drop it, then... Because our goal is to push this in front of the laser. That's what we need to do. Is it just not possible? Side of the wall. So I can easily do this, but then that will instant kill me, or nearly instant kill me. Let's read this tablet. Art thou the chosen one or not? Proceed, we shall wait for thee ahead. So there is some cool stuff I can do over there, but I just don't know if it's worth trying. Can I squeeze through somehow? I don't think that's possible. Maybe I need a double jump. Alright. Well, that aside, there is something we can do. Which is over... Oh, wait. Can we not get up there? Actually can't get up there. Oh no. This is a disaster. Alright, let's go down. Well, that's a bit embarrassing. Two puzzles that I can't do because I don't have double jump. I guess this is why I usually do Temple of the Moon first. I think that's where I want to be. But we're having fun. Definitely to be enjoyed. And we have a life orb. That means we can do some of this area. The skeleton takes a lot of hits. Oh, yeah, we have to get back up. All of the name that means unnamed. So that's a clue for a room that's just... Oh. Somehow I did not remember that. That instant kill trap. I thought we were so good with that life jewel. Well, this time through, we know that apparently there's no puzzles that we can actually solve here. The axe does have a big swing, so at least makes those things pretty easy to deal with. Alright, this time we're not gonna die to the mysterious instant death trap. We're gonna get bounced around, but we're not gonna die to it. So this is the Tower of Inferno, which is the backside of the Inferno Cavern, as you might guess. It being the backside, it is much more of a pain in the butt. Especially because we do not have double jump. Not having double jump might prevent us from getting most places we need to go. We can barely make these jumps. Ooh. Alright. It might be time to give up on that, because... Is that really where I need to go anyway? Let's try going back to the Temple of the Sun. We're gonna go to Temple of the Moon this time. Actually, maybe let's talk to Mulbra. The thing you have, it's called a laptop, correct? How fancy. Mulberg has seen something similar before. There's a wall with directions on how to make one of those things move written on it. So that is a hint that there's a wall mural with some code. We can't do anything with that information yet, though. Ow, ow, ow. I'm tired, and stone floors make poor beds. Work is sleeping. Alright. So we have a couple possible entrances into the Tower of the Moon or Temple of the Moon. We can go in there, and maybe we will. There's some things that we want to do in here. Actually to the right. He's pretty cool. Oh, he's immune to my attacks. Uh-oh. Getting all confused. Say hi to Mulbrook again. Snort. It's sometimes good to check in on her, because sometimes she has something to say, but as soon as she starts meandering about sleeping, then it stops being important. There's a lot we gotta do still. Before we're ready to finish the Temple of the Moon. Yeah, we got some ghosts. I guess maybe we should come down here and read this tablet. Water will provide the power for the tower to soar the skies. I've heard a little bit about the tower being provided with power from the spring of the sky. It's a clue. Oh, that's right. Cannot use my weapon inside of Mother. Should've remembered. Got another sleepy guy. Should go down there? No. Okay, there's nothing there. We're gonna go up to the top. So the world has opened up a little bit in that we want to go to Eden. Don't know if I can actually finish Eden yet. And of course there's the twin labyrinths over there, but the twin labyrinths they're so far from being ready. Try going through here one more time. So, there's a lot of puzzles in here. And I think we might want to go the wrong way before we solve this. That might be a good idea. Let's try going the wrong way. Oh no, we went the right way. That's actually not what I wanted to do. Alright, let's back it up. Man, those dragons are so tough. Snow, yeah, okay. Alright. We already came all the way over here, we might as well go to the giant area. There is something we want to do. Can we not go through this? There's no map. I think that this was correct. Hope we didn't break this puzzle. It might be that I was supposed to do it the other way. I can't remember. Yeah, it seems like I did this wrong. Okay, well, this ice block comes down. There we go. That's not the worst thing in the world. Not particularly good, but... oh, we're so close to the opening there. Yeah, what to do? What to do? So many areas. We have, like, no money. Alright. Can't do anything with the Chamber of Extinction, I don't think. I mean, I guess we could. Maybe I'll check out the Inferno Cavern. I don't know if I fully finished this spot. Let me see. Yeah, that looks good. Shop here. I swear I already went here, but I must have died. Oh yes, that's right. We don't have enough money. Already got the weapon there. Alright. Take the plunge. Alright, there's something we're supposed to do there later, I think. But that's okay. There's a passageway here. This passageway goes to here. This place is a huge mess. Starting to get to the point where the enemies are worth enough. Oh wait. What boss is this? Oh no. I'm not even gonna bother fighting him. He will kill me. Alright, well, I mean, I guess the best thing I can do is at least get that help up. So we'll go to the fire area. It's not exactly where I want to be going. But I know that there's help there, and I need help. Health is a very desirable upgrade in this game. I really have no idea why I can't do this puzzle. I thought I didn't need to jump, but obviously I messed up somehow. There we go. Can I do this area without falling into the instant death trap? I swear, it never gets me. But in this run, it's gotten me twice in a row. Swim across the other side. Is there a way? There might be a platform I can jump onto. Yeah. Never mind. I just won't go through that spike crap. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I swear I've never had trouble with that before. Alright, well that I should have known. Kind and mischievous spirit, a lonely and mischievous spirit. She means no harm with her mischief. No damage done by unintentional mischief. Cool. We want to go to the right. There was a race that recorded their knowledge on the walls. This knowledge will operate in a mechanical box as a virtual wise man. It shall awaken should a wise man read the mural. So this is connecting up what I think Malbrook was telling us, which is that there is a mural on the wall which contains code for running a virtual wise man, aka a computer. And that'll be interesting at some point. Right now, it's nothing we can really do anything about. All right. lightning guy. Watching my health, but it's not looking good. There we go. Alright. Yeah, now we can't actually get up there. That is dangerous. So I won't do that. Oh, great bird, give us mercy. Will crushing thy hand bring us mercy? Yes. Still can't do this without double jump. Yeah, because I don't know if I can get up here. Doesn't seem like it. Okay, so that might be about as far as I can get in this room also. We're getting there. Killing the mini-boss. You know, it's still progress. Life gem, mini-boss. Open up evil. Video here, and we'll try again next time. We'll try to be picking up some new special items. I guess we're about halfway through the game. Sounds about right. So I'll see you then.